Okay. You were born a scientist. You are naturally inclined to study your surroundings, challenge your limits, learn through trial and error, and imagine relentlessly. Every atom in your body came from a star that once exploded. It is likely that the atoms of your left hand were spawned of a different stellar body than those of your right. It is hard to fathom that your own physical existence is credited to an imbalance among the gravity and mass of a burning ball of gas. And yet, this is our stork. The living, functioning force that permits existence itself. We are breathing, thinking, wandering creatures of the universe, and to our knowledge, we are the only species capable of such. Carl Sagan once noted that due to our atomic foundations, we all genuinely are star stuff. As far as humans know, we are the only species of star stuff with the capacity to wonder, reflect, and inquire about the universe. Therefore, we are messengers, navigators, and explorers that the universe has purposefully placed to allow itself to reflect upon itself. And so, we are born scientists with an incredible need to know and an important responsibility to try. As children, we immediately begin fulfilling our responsibility. Our unlimited curiosity demands action, and we are unleashed to the world on a quest for understanding. Then, we go to school. Organized education becomes sort of a priority for us. Math, science, history, English, pouring from the pages of a textbook written by a stranger directly into our vulnerable minds. No more exploration, no more adventure. We begin to absorb lessons of someone else's discovery rather than embarking on our own. Our drive for discovery, our most distinguishable quality separating us from the other animals of Earth, is silenced. Only facts, information, knowledge. All pre-processed, waiting to be memorized, with a label of failure for those who do not do so. This, however, is never how I've defined failure. Failure to me is someone who looks at something they have never seen before and feels no sense of awe. Failure is allowing suffering to leave you empty-handed. Failure is taking the path of least resistance. It is settling for anything less than what you deserve. To abandon your sense of wonder is failure. Can you count how many times you've been handed a paper with a red F on the top? That stupid, all-encompassing letter that threatens your whole future, the college that will accept you if your parents will let you go out that night. Nothing hurts quite like an F. Not good enough, stupid, failure. Some may be thinking, I've never gotten an F. Some may be realizing they've gotten too many to count. And that is okay. Because today is new, and it is demanding your attention. You may begin again, but this time more intelligently. And I hope that that excites you beyond any excitement you have ever experienced before, because this will probably never happen for you again. 12 years through a structured system of education have filled us with a wealth of knowledge, but regretfully, it has caused each of us to neglect that small inner voice that calls to us, seek more, a voice you have been gifted with by virtue of being human. Luckily, today is day one all over again, a second chance some of us have needed. You are reborn, and whether you have elected to enter the working field, continue your education, or join the service, this is your moment. The right time is now. Challenge yourself to look deep into who you are and reawaken your sense of wonder. Learn something from everyone you encounter. Say what you need to. Baffle people with the craft of your thoughts. Seek passion. Delve into it and never stop. Go deeper than anyone else has ever dared because lack of passion is fatal. Recall that sometimes the hardest thing and the right thing are the same, and do not for one second believe in the criticism of someone who is unaware of the absolute greatness that you are. Never underestimate the problems before you or your ability to solve them. Most of all, watch with glittering eyes the whole world around you. Your life and your education up until now may have given you your fill to eat, but never lose your hunger. The greatest of secrets dwell in the most unlikely places. Seize the moment to go forth and seek them. Embrace your sense of wonder. For it is a rare quality, a gift of the universe at the foundations of humanity that should never be wasted. Should you remember this, Should you set forth into the world as the scientist you were born to be, you will flourish, discover, understand, and you will never fail. Congratulations and best of luck to the class of 2013.